What's up guys, it's your boy, still needs an intro, and today we're finally putting new wheels on the truck. Now this journey actually began a few months ago when I was on the hunt for some new tires for it. Well, new to me anyway. The issue was, I was looking for tires for these knockoff American Racing rims that you see on the back here. Now prepubescent Jesse put on these rims about 4 or 5 years ago, but the problem with it is, these rims are a very small diameter, but very wide. They are 15 inch by 10 and a half, meaning the only two kinds of tires that fit on these rims are either Mud Grappler Rock Crawler 9000s or 15 inch Mickey Thompson drag slicks. So then began the hunt of just finding a new set of rims. These ones were a little old, they're a little worn out, the paint's peeling, etc. But then I ran into the second problem. Everything that fits this truck would either A, buy wheels that need new tires, putting me in the same situation that I'm in right now, or B, it's a $2,000 set of 14 wides that, again, I don't want to put on this truck. And then everything changed when I found the Facebook group OEM Wheels on Other Makes and Models, where people like to do things like put Tesla Model 3 wheels on this vehicle, or put Corvette saw blades on this vehicle, or put Tesla Model 3 wheels on this vehicle, or put Corvette saw blades on this vehicle, or Tesla wheels on this vehicle, or saw blades on this vehicle. So then I began to look into bolt patterns, and what I found was pretty interesting. Most vehicles with a 6-lug bolt pattern are going to have relatively the same bolt pattern. Now these are listed as 6 by 5.5, but then I had to think outside of my dumb American brain and consider, what are these in millimeters? So then I found 6 by 137.9. And you know what other vehicle has 6 by 137.9? The latest and greatest Ford Bronco. But things could never go that easy for me, could they? So the issue we ran into was offset. Now with the Ford Bronco having a very high positive offset, meaning where it mounts to the hub, it goes in towards the body, meaning it rubbed on this. So what did we have to do? Buy 2-inch spacers to make it fit. So now with these new spacers installed, you can see the fitment on this is beautiful. All right, back wheel's done. Let's see how they look. And if we take a look this way, they run pretty flush too. That fitment is great. Same thing as the back, the fitment is wonderful on those. Like, just look at how close to flush that is. That is wonderful. God, those look so good. Yeah, buddy. Oh my goodness, that's great. Look at that. I got a haircut. Now I did film an outro whenever I was actually recording, but I didn't realize that my microphone wasn't connected. And so I'm sitting here talking the entire time and there's actually no audio coming out. So it's pretty sweet. But if you found this video helpful or at least entertaining, please be sure to drop a like and share it with your friends. If you'd consider subscribing, click over here. If you want to see what YouTube recommends you watch next, click over here. And as always, I look forward to seeing you guys next time.